Alright, what is up you guys, and welcome to another video from yours truly, The Scarinder. So yeah, I'm gonna start this off as cliche as possible. You know, I really didn't want to make this video. Of course I did. But I was trying to rethink how do I tackle this. Like, I'm gonna do this in one sitting, how does it make the most sense? And quite frankly, this is just about the Gen 1 pandering, and I'm not here to change your opinion about that. I'm really gonna say that straight off the bat. If you think the newest trailer of Pokemon was fine, more power to you. I really couldn't tell you otherwise. I mean, I'm gonna buy the game no matter what, but I'm gonna critique the game for what I see. And I actually think the Korokoro League before ruined the trailer to an extent, because all of a sudden we only got to see new moves and a new form of Butterfree, which was actually the highlight no matter what. The Meowth situation was awesome too. it actually was. But I think people got really frustrated here, and the major response was just that, why do we keep reinventing the first generation? Look, they cut the Mega Pokemon, which means the Kanto Pokemon is now just as unviable as it was before. So seeing and getting some type of extra evolution is fine, but I think the base form kinda did people no good, as seeing base forms getting a second evolution, I guess you could call it, made it look kind of silly. At least for my sake, it definitely felt like that. Though I do recognize that both Eevee and Pikachu could very well be the Eevees and Pikachu from Let's Go. And if so, you're forced to have Let's Go to get that Pikachu. Jesus. That's dumb. However, like I said, I do recognize that that's the way to go about things, and they need to, of course, go for Gen 1 pairing. I'm pretty sure Game Freak has no creative decisions in that. I definitely believe Pokemon is the one leading that aspect, as they want to resell Charizards, they want to resell Pikachus, they are the most popular Pokemon. No way going out about that. If you sell 3 plushies, you sell as much as the game itself. Trust me, they're selling more plushies. So there are money to be made in making toys and plushies and cards and posters, whatever. Pokemon is not the main income there. And most likely, as I said before, that's the moneymaker. So they need to reinvent the old Pokemon. It is as simple as that, and I can recognize that. But the reason I made this video is because of all the white knighting, I would say, mindless defense of Pokemon. Look, I'm not gonna, like, pinpoint which PokeTubers does this, but I'm gonna at least tell you one that I think did right, and that was Shofu. I don't necessarily watch Shofu's content, but he was the only one that I am aware of that actually critiqued this creative direction, because, quite frankly, he said, sure, little Timmy could appreciate Charizard, but what if little Timmy liked Delphox or Greninja? They may very well not be in the game. How should he feel about this? You can't just oversell the first generation Pokemons to because they are actually built towards me. They're built to the people that have played the game far too long, 20 years now, that's awful, to get us to be excited about the game, and more so, maybe even, you know, as my offspring was going to say, my daughter, maybe just very well get herself a fat Pikachu, because I like Pikachu. That's the direction we're getting at, and I think that's awful. I absolutely believe that being so mindlessly pandering Generation 1 into the games are annoying, and the most reactions here was that people are tired of this. People were absolutely on the fence about this and was really, really irritated, and then we had PokeTubers mindlessly defending Game Freak and dumbfolding people and calling them idiots or dumb or needy, and you have no—I'm sorry to say it—but you have no input or argument here. Your opinion, as a bigger PokeTuber, if you just mindlessly agree with Game Freak, your opinion is irrelevant, as you don't work with Game Freak. For first off, you have no creative direction whatsoever; hence, your opinion is invalidated by default. But also, you trying to create some type of media storm around smaller people, really, to hope that somebody agrees with you, or your fan base is mindlessly following you and attack that very same person. I got attacked the other day, and it didn't bother me at all, as I know a bunch of these guys are just kids. And they are. And that's alright. Kids are kids. But I really just wanted to, it didn't matter what my opinion was. People were looking for that. They were looking on a hate stream because a certain people was hating on me. And even though his opinion was invalidated by default, it didn't matter. And I think that's really frustrating to kind of cover. And I don't believe anybody should be attacked for their opinion, even more so when you're critiquing a product that you have no point of making or have any creative directions in. I'm sorry to say it, but Game Freak are doing these trailers to get critique. If you don't see that, you are just don't know how marketing works. You release a trailer to see the reaction. If they're positive, that's great. That means that they've made a good direction on their part. But if you get a backlash, much like the national deck was kind of developing, that's when you need to make something happen. Most likely, they're just showcasing this to showcase that they are in the game, and they got probably the direction they wanted to, which means that people were excited about Butterfree, which was a good part of them not giving Korokoro that information. But even more so, I really can't stress this enough, they probably wasn't expecting the backlash on the Eve Pikachu to Meowth. I mean, people were laughing about Meowth, of course they were, but I think most people kind of reacted in a way they hopefully didn't want to, which was that they, besides all the positivity, there were a backlash. A lot of people responded that this is one generation that just gets too much love, and it's starting to be more them that create that love more than the community itself. And community has affected Pokemon before. As I said, the National Dex movement, while at times kind of needy and actually quite destructive, it did force Pokemon, or Game Freak, I should say, to respond to the community. That has never happened before, and it also means that they're not so out of touch with the community as one might think. The reaction they got from the National Dex movement probably forced Nintendo's hand, if anything, because it didn't matter what Nintendo was making, for example, the Link's Awakening remake, everything most people remember are that Game Freak interview, and that's how big that was. It killed Nintendo's E3 conference as a whole, because this information just was too big to handle for most people, including me. I thought it was an awful decision, but it's not my place to take that decision. However, it's my place to absolutely critique it and think that it's wrong. And many people felt the same way, which is why Nintendo most likely said to Game Freak, or more likely Pokemon, fucking fix this. Because they need not only to save face, but they also need to reassure their money income. You are absolutely the money bag they want to have. And if you're just saying yes to the game and are not going to take it, you're not going to be important to them. You are just money. And that's the thing. I'm gonna buy the game, most likely no matter what. I'll already buy a Switch, and I bought a freaking capture card device, you know, I'm there already. I'm not dumb, I'm just stressed out, nope. It won't stop me from buying a game, like, it won't stop me from even if I buy the game, I can still critique the game. Like, that's what reviews is all about, critiquing what works and what doesn't. They want a response, they're going to get the response. Ultra Sun and Moon, for example, could very well have been DLC. Most people, after some time, agree with me on that. First off, I got attacked a ton by saying it should have been DLC at first, but it was very clear that once people were done with the game that, shit, this was just a cash grab. Fuck you, Game Freak, this was awful. But what I'm trying to say is that it's so important to critique the products that they're showcasing, because if they don't get critique, how in the hell should they develop as a company? They're already showcasing, they are involved with the community, they are listening to us, and while most likely it needs to be really big backlash for them to try to fix or respond to it, it still showcases that they are listening to critiques, they want critique. And if you're just gonna blindly agree and try to witch hunt people who think differently because you are just blindlessly following and saying yes to everything they showcase, I'm sorry, but you are in wrong here. You really are. The Gen 1 pandering is real, and it's real for a very real reason. They are here to make money after all, and I can respect them for that. But I won't say that it's a good thing. And I actually think that people that are critiquing this as something that is pandering are in the right to do so without being scared of people of a different opinion that just mindlessly agree and to witch hunt them. Because that's not how things works. I hate social media because of this, because it doesn't matter if your argument is valid or not. You're just by default ignored because of somebody else that are bigger than you, just are not seeing eye to eye, and even worse, just are really, really dumb. Yes, I'm calling person to disagree with Gabriel blindly dumb, because you are just hand out giving them money without actually required something back. And as I said here, you need to critique the products you're buying. The point of a review later on in line are to get the response you want. You want to know what's good, you want to know what's bad, to get better next time you do something. We're gonna have more Pokemon games. Trust me, the National Dex movement is absolutely going to affect them next time. I am very, very sure it will. And if you don't think that, joke's on you, because just wait this out. But yeah, what I'm trying to get is that Gen 1ers, you're welcome. But really, critique the game as much as you want to, and try to be better. Try to ask for better stuff. And if you are blindlessly following Game Freak, good on you. More power to you. But don't attack people that are of a different opinion because you think you're going to have a statement, because you are not working with Game Freak, and if you aren't, your opinion is invalidated by default. You can't defend a company with a creative decision if you don't have a creative decision in that company. It's really, really dumb, and I don't get that. So anyway, guys, as always, thank you for watching. I hope this video wasn't too weird. I really don't like to make this content. I actually don't. But I also really wanted to speak my mind, so I took the time to do just that. So guys, as always, take care, have a great day. Bye.